class of chemicals called per- and polyfluorinated alkyl substances, or PFAS, are commonly referred to as forever chemicals because they're very persistent and they're found virtually everywhere, in global water supplies, soil and air, and even the blood of humans and animals. I am Peter Jaffé. I'm a professor in the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering. There are about 8,000 different PFAS, and they're used in all kinds of products, such as firefighting foam, nonstick pans, and pizza boxes. The two most common ones are PFOA and PFOS, for which EPA has issued health guidelines because they have been linked with harmful health effects. What makes them so persistent is the strength of the carbon-fluorine bond, which is the strongest covalent bond in organic chemistry and nearly impossible to break down. So these chemicals stick around a long time after they've been used. This is especially true for the per- or fully fluorinated compounds like PFOA and PFOS. My team has discovered a bacterium called acidobacterium A6 that is capable of breaking down this bond and biodegrade these harmful chemicals. A big challenge, however, is that these bacteria are very slow growing, and we are currently looking at ways that we could speed up this production, for which we are developing novel bioelectrochemical reactors and novel means of supplying required nutrients. Once this can be done, these bacteria have the potential to be grown at sites that have high concentrations of PFAS, such as airports, naval facilities, and wastewater treatment plants. We are also exploring their use for applications like remediations of PFAS-contaminated biosolids and in situ treatment of contaminated sediments. This is the first time that an organism has been shown to break down perfluorinated compounds, including PFOA and PFOS, and we think it could be a highly effective means of cleaning up PFAS-contaminated systems.